How are you all? I hope that you all are fine. My name is Virda Nirali from Saraswati Group of Education. And today, in our session 2, we are going to start with our vocabulary session and pronunciation part. But before that, let's have a quick recap that what we have learned in our previous session. कि अपने अपना अपना पहला ना सेशन में सो लर्न करो तो सो वी हैव अंडरस्टूड द वोकैबुलरी वर्ड्स एंड द चैप्टर राइट सो इन दिस चैप्टर व्हाट इज द स्टोरी ऑफ दिस चैप्टर दैट दिस इज द स्टोरी दैट हैव टू ब्रदर्स राइट द नेम ऑफ द ब्रदर्स आर विल्बुर एंड और विले राइट सो दिस टू ब्रदर्स दे हैव इन्वेंटेड हाउ दे हैव इन्वेंटेड द एरोप्लेन through their determination it let them form a rain and hard work now there is a real life story so this chapter is was all about a real life story ke aeroplane che eno invention keve rite thyu to and kone karyu to so this was the story of that this is the real story that changed the way people travel long distance and after this इन्वेंशन आई मेन्शन थू एना पछी एने घणा लोकोनो एक वे चेन्ज करी नाख्यो बाय थिंकिंग नो के दे केन ट्रावल अ लॉन्ग डिस्टन्स इन अ शॉर्ट टाइम पीरियड ऑल्सो एंड दे केन फ्लाय इन द एर राइट सो द पीपल्स ड्रीम कैन ऑल्सो बी फुलफिल्ड दैट येस दे केन फ्लाय लाइक अ बर्ड इन द एर सो दिस वॉज द स्टोरी अबाउट द एरोप्लेन द इन्वेंशन ऑफ द एरोप्लेन who made that? The Wright brothers, Orville and Wilbur, right? Now, we are going to start with our vocabulary session. In that, I'm writing a sentence over here. Many attempts were made to improve the hot air balloon and the glider Now next many trials were made to better the hot air balloon and the glider. Now, I'm underlining two words over here in both the sentences, right? Over here, I have underlined attempts and improve, and over here, I have underlined trials and better. So, now again, let's read the sentence. Many attempts, and chaji badi koshisho karwa mai bhi, so ke hot air balloon and a glider ne improve karwa. And many trials, improve the same meaning, the hot air balloon and the glider. Trials. So attempts and trials, meaning same as sides. But we have written the different words. The same goes over here. Improve and better. Meaning But though we have written different words, so such kind of words where the meaning is same, right? But there are different words with almost there. So I say, there were different words, but in a same meaning, So such kind of words are known as synonyms, right? એટલે કે એક જેવો જેનો મીનિંગ થતો હોય એવા વર્ડ્સને સિનોનિમ્સ કહેવામાં આવે છે ઓકે સચ વર્ડ્સ આર નોન એઝ સિનોનિમ્સ hope that you get it. What I am trying to say means having a same kind of meaning. Synonyms means nothing. It's just mean that having same kind of meaning. Okay? So, we are going to solve the exercise related to this thing. Okay? So, let's get started. Options.
They were not able to stay in the air
wrong enough. They were not able to stay in the air long enough. Now, though they could jump easily, ye log ko easily jump kari sakta tha pehla khate. They were not able to stay in the air long enough. આપણે જમ્પ કરીએ તો કઈ શું આપણે હવામાં જ થોડી બઝ નીચે મૂટે રાખી. સો વી વિલ ફોલ ડાઉન. એટલે શું કહે છે, ધે વર નોટ એ હવામાં લાંબો ટાઈમ સુધી નહોતા રહી શકતા. ધે વર નોટ એબલ ટુ સ્ટે ઇન ધ એર લોંગ ઇનફ. નાઉ હિયર ધ વર્ડ ઇઝીલી ઇઝ ધેર, રાઈટ? તો ક્રિએટિંગ તો લાઈક એઝ આઈ ટોલ્ડ યુ, સો ધ વર્ડ વિચ મેચિસ ઇઝીલી ઇઝ એફર્ટલેસલી. અને જરાય એફર્ટ કર્યા વગર, આપણે એટલી મહેનત કર્યા વગર આપણને ઇઝીલી મળી જતું. સો દેટ ઇઝ ઇઝીલી એફર્ટલેસલી. સો ઇન ધ પ્લેસ ઓફ ઇઝીલી વી વિલ રાઇટ એફર્ટલેસલી. એન્ડ સ્ટે મીન્સ રિમેઇન. સ્ટે મીન્સ રિમેઇન, હજી અહીંયા જ. સો દેટ વી વિલ રાઇટ રિમેઇન. So now let's read the sentence. Though they could jump effortlessly, they were not able to remain in the air for long enough. So there is no change in the meaning of the sentence by changing two words, because they are having the same kind of a meaning. That's why there is no changes at all. Now the third one. The Wright brothers had a hobby of inventing things. So over here I am going to underline this inventing. ઇન્વેન્ટ કરવું એટલે કંઈક નવું બનાવવું. સો ક્રિએટિંગ ઇઝ એઝ આઈ ટોલ્ડ ઇટ મીન્સ ટુ મેક સમથિંગ ન્યૂ. રાઇટ બ્રધર્સની શું હોબી હતી કે એને નવી નવી વસ્તુ બનાવવી બહુ ગમતી હતી. સો ધ વર્ડ વિચ ઇઝ સિમિલર ટુ ઇન્વેન્ટિંગ ઇઝ ક્રિએટિંગ. ધ રાઇટ બ્રધર્સ હેડ અ હોબી ઓફ ક્રિએટિંગ થિંગ્સ. ઓકે, નાઉ ધ નેક્સ્ટ word is, let me cut this word. Now the fourth one is, both the brothers were good engineers. Both the brothers were good engineers, which was essential in order to build, which was essential in order to build a flying machine. Now, both the brothers were good engineers. Good, as I told you, good means excellent. So we can write good in the place of, write excellent in the place of good. And which was essential, like jaruri hatu. Necessary, jaruri. Over here we will write necessary and cut this. Okay, so fourth head, you must know the meaning. તમને જો આ words ના meaning આવડતા હોય કે આનો meaning શું થાય, then only you can will be able to solve. So that's why only we are learning the vocabulary words, right? So we come to know that yes, ano meaning same thai che. For that, if you don't know, you can refer out on internet, Google. Then you can also use to learn, means you can also read out the dictionary, refer it out. Now the fifth one, so it was only a matter of time. So it was only a matter of time before they achieved their dreams. Achieved. એટલે આપણે કંઈક હાસિલ કર્યું. Right? So it was only a matter of time before they realized that. They realized almost some similar kind of a meaning. Right? Almost similar word meaning like that. Dreams. Now, the next is Wilbur and Orville. Wilbur and Orville studied the glider closely. Now I'm going to underline closely એટલે બહુ ધ્યાનથી બહુ સરખી રીતે. So that means brief એટલે તો મોટું. હવે આપણી પાસે થ્રી વર્ડ્સ છે, carefully, ધ્યાનથી, tough, એ તો hard થઈ ગયું. So closely means carefully. So we are going to write carefully over here. Now the next is, these involved a lot of hard work. This involved a lot of hard work and difficult mathematical calculations So I'm going to underline difficult. It's hard, so difficult means tough. This involved a lot of hard work and a tough mathematical calculation. Now, the next is, however, the aeroplane could stay up in the air only for a very short period of time. Short, brief, only a brief period of time. Okay? So in this way, you are supposed to see the word, and if you know the correct meaning, then you can easily identify that which word will replace which word. કયો વર્ડ રિપ્લેસ કરી દેશે વિધાઉટ ચેન્જિંગ ધ મીનિંગ ઓફ ધ સેન્ટેન્સ, કે સેન્ટેન્સનો એમાં મીનિંગ પણ ચેન્જ ના થાય એવી રીતે. ઓકે, સો ધીસ વોઝ ઓલ અબાઉટ સિનોનિમ્સ. નાઉ વી આર મૂવિંગ ટુવર્ડ્સ આર પ્રોનન્સિએશન પાર્ટ. Okay, so now we are going to learn to now the pronunciation, that is, CH is having a two different sound. The letter CH is having two different sound, that is CH, and first we'll see CH sound. When CH is used as a CH sound, such as watch, chip, chain, right? Then after word, the next word is bunch, lunch. So you can see over here the CH is having CH sound. And now over here CH is used as the sound K. Character, stomach, Christmas. Right? So CH can be used as both the letter CH is having a two different kind of sounds, that is CH sound and G sound. So in some words we pronounce it as CH and in some words we pronounce it as K. Okay? So you are supposed to solve the exercise based on this. You have to read the sentence and you have to identify that which sound is there, ch or the k sound. If it is ch sound, then you have to mark that word with yellow crayon, and if it is k sound, then you are supposed to mark that word with green crayon. Let me explain you two of the sentences, the rest you will do it by yourself. Okay? So, now you can see I have written three sentences over here. The rest two you will do it by yourself. Okay? At least you will try to do it by yourself. So now, first we will underline that which word is having a CH in that word, letter CH. So this and this. Now over here, CH is pronounced at what? Ch sound. So if this is ch sound, so you will mark this color with yellow crayon. And this is Christmas, k sound. So you will mark this word with green crayon. Now over here, CH, CH. CH, CH. Okay? Now this is stomach, k sound. So green crayon, ek. Ek and a duku. So this is also k sound. So green crayon, cheese, ch sound. Yellow crayon, sandwich, ch sound. So again, yellow crayon. First, just mark the sign word which is having CH in their word. So chameleon, k sound. So green crayon, chair, ch sound. So that will be yellow crayon. So in this way, you are supposed to identify that which word is having the sound of ch and which word is having the sound of k. So this was all about the pronunciation, that CH is having the two different kinds of pronunciation, ch and k. So today we have learned the synonyms and the pronunciation. I hope that you have understood that very well. And I will also send you the worksheet related to this, which you are supposed to solve it in your book. Okay, students? So till then, bye-bye. Thank you. Take good care of yourself.